Hello, my dear friends. Today, I will show you the most important pillars in the natal chart of each of us that help all of us to discover if we are compatible in personal relationships with somebody else. First of all, let's take an example of chart, doesn't matter to whom it is. The most important pillars are the ascendant. This ascendant gives to each of you your physical appearance, your vitality, and your personality. Moon. It shows your emotion and thoughts. And this is very important in relationships. Sun. It's also your vitality and your physical appearance. But also, it's important because it shows longevity of the relationship, the potential relationship, a potential longevity. Also, this is the sun, right? And Venus, it's about love and tenderness and erotic feelings and pleasure, right? Attraction, physical attraction, beauty, romantic moods, okay? So these are the four pillars that shows for each of you the possibility and the potential of quality and longevity of your personal relationships. So I will give you some examples of couples, of public people that proved in time that they are able to have long relationships. So, first of all, Tom Hanks and Rita Wilson, they are together starting with 1988. So, what we can see between these four pillars? Let's look at the ascendant. So, the ascendant of Rita is in Sagittarius, and ascendant of Tom is in Virgo. This is not quite a compatibility, right? So there are different compatibility, different personality. But remember that not the ascendant gives you the longevity of the relationship. Let's see the moon. Rita's moon is in Leo, and Tom's room is also in Leo. In a large orb, there is a conjunction. Conjunction is a powerful connection between two planets, two people. So they have similarity in emotions and thoughts and feelings. So this is very important, and it's a fixed sign, Leo. So it's a fixed, this is a, like a super glue that is help them to keep together in this relationship. The sun. Rita's sun is in Scorpio, and Tom's sun is in Cancer. So both of them are water signs, so they are compatible. It's a trine relationship between these two suns, and this gives the longevity of the relationship. Venus Rita's Venus is near Jupiter in Virgo, and Venus, Tom's Venus is in Gemini. It's a square relationship, so maybe on the physical compatibility they are not quite compatible, but let's remember this, even it's a square combination aspect that is tough, right? What is the link between these two? So Venus in Gemini and Venus in Virgo, they have a common ruler, and it's Mercury. Let's see what has happened with the Mercury in their chart. In the chart, her Mercury is in Libra, and his Mercury is in Cancer. Also, it's a square. Here we don't have such something in common, a powerful link. So the most powerful link between them is the Sun, longevity of relationship, and the Moon, emotions and feelings. So for them, this is the super glue of the relationship. Okay? Let's see what I want to say until then. It's about what is the most important when it's about aspects. The most important aspect that brings powerful connection on a long term is, maybe you will not believe, but opposition, because it's an attraction between complementary needs and behavior and personality. It's an attraction because this polarity and opposition brings us the need of each other, right? The trine means that the planets are in the water sign, earth sign, air sign, or fire sign. As I said, the Sun, the Tom's Sun is in Cancer, and Rita's Sun is in Scorpio. This is an example. Square, it's difficult because it brings conflicts. Of course, if they are able to go through conflicts to solve some issues, it's perfect, but not all the time it happened this. And of course, doesn't bring too much longevity of the relationship. And also, very important, the conjunction between the planets. As I said, for this example, it's about Moon, because Moon, for both of them, are in the same sign, near to each other in Leo. The aspect of sextile, it's good, but it's not so powerful, so I will not take it in account. What is also important to see the relationship between these four planets or points, ascendant, Moon, Sun, and Venus, and their relationship with the benefics of the other person. So let's see. Saturn is not so near on the Sun. Saturn of the Tom is far away from Sun of Rita, so it's not the case actually. Here also, because they are the same generation, of course the Jupiter is in the same sign, even it's a big difference between the orb. So it's not a quite an aspect. Let's see here. Here also Mars. But Mars, it's about action, generally speaking. So they have the same, in the same place, sign in Pisces, Mars. So here we don't have such cases. Let's see the next example. It's about Goldie Hawn and Kurt Russell. If you don't know who are they, look up them in recent periods, older, but they are quite charming together, and they are very funny together, actually. I like them very much. Let's see in their case. Goldie Hawn and Kurt Russell. So, the ascendant, as you see here, is very nice. Ascendant of Goldie is in Sagittarius, and the ascendant of Kurt is in Cancer, so it's an opposition, and opposition is the most powerful, right? So it's a quite an attraction. Another one. Let's see the Moon. The Moon, his her Moon is in Gemini and his Moon is in Cancer. They don't see each other, so it's not good, it's not bad. It's not an aspect. So maybe they have different in feelings and thoughts. But this means that this is not the main importance of this. So attraction, permanent attraction between them, because they are very different in personalities, they attract each other like a magnet. Like South Pole and North Pole, yeah? Sun. Her Sun is in Scorpio. His Sun is in Pisces. So, a quite good connection, a trine between water elements. And as I said, Sun is giving the longevity in relationship. What we have? Venus. Her Venus is in Scorpio and his Venus is in Aries. So it's not quite a combination. There is no combination. There's not connection between them through an aspect. But which is the common ruler for Scorpio and Aries? It's about, and sorry, and yes, Scorpio and Aries. It's about Mars. As you know, Mars is the traditional ruler for Scorpio, and Mars is the main ruler of Aries. So let's see where are these planets in their chart. So her Mars is in Leo and his Mars is in Aries. So we have a trine aspect, because the ruler of a sign is like a leader that it gives a command. It gives, do it like this because it's good for you. This is doing Mars for each of them to the main house and the planets that are placed in that house. For example, for Goldie, Mars is in Leo and is giving the command to the 12th house, where is Venus and Sun in Scorpio. And both of them are fixed sign, so stable, yeah, stable situation. For Cart, Venus and Mars, they are in the same house, the fifth house. Okay, so Mars in Aries, that is in his own rulership and very good place, right? Is together and give the command to the Venus. So this is good for them. The next example is about John Lennon and Yoko Ono. And this example, even he died, unfortunately, in that very ugly crime moment when a crazy person killed him, they had quite a good relationship. Let's see what has happened here. So, we again have her ascendant in Libra in opposition with his ascendant in Aries. So it's a quite of attraction, a big attraction. So this is very important. Then let's see the moon. Her moon is in Sagittarius and his moon is in Aquarius. It's not a trine, it's a sextile, but still it's a good aspect that bring compatibility between their each other emotions and thoughts. When we are looking to the sun, she used to have sun in Aquarius and he used to have sun in Libra. So it's a trine between air elements, Libra and Aquarius, and this bring longevity. Of course, this longevity has been killed by this killing, but otherwise, if he used to be alive even now, for sure they could be together still. And let's see what about Venus. Her Venus is in Aquarius and his Venus is in Virgo. Here is not an aspect. So on the one of them it was air and another earth, so it's not quite a compatibility here. But let's see their rulers. The ruler of the Virgo is Mercury, and Mercury is in Scorpio here, and the ruler of Aquarius is Saturn, and here we have in Taurus. And surprise, Taurus and Mercury are in opposition, so a big attraction. Okay, Saturn is a malefic, but near the malefic it's a benefic. So, no matter what, we go on the good side.